so much for pressing play and taking time out of your day to spend with me. This is Joy. Welcome to another video. Today I want to talk to you about why you must not confront a narcissist. And when I say confront a narcissist, I mean tell them about themselves, how they make you feel, or that you know that they're a narcissist. Some questions that, you know, I think you should consider before you do that is like, at the end of the day, what do you want your results to be? Why do you want to confront them? Do you truly believe that the act of confronting them will give you a desired result? Do you think it will change their behavior? What essentially you are going to do is awaken a sleeping giant. It's almost as though they decide that, how dare you call me out on my foolishness, because they truly know that what they do is evil. They know. There is no confusion when it comes to that. They know, and they enjoy it. They are there. They are part of it. They plan it. They plot it. They salivate over it. They are fully aware, and they have no problems. You see, they lack empathy. And without that empathy, they have no conscience. They have absolutely zero feelings of guilt. And so what you'll find is that they'll ridicule you about how you feel. And getting into that type of discussion with them gives them ample amounts of narcissistic supply, because you know, with narcissists, they have the ability to twist things around, and they will start to make you, they'll start with a crazy making and make you appear to be the one with the issue. And when all is said and done, they will walk away and go and sleep peacefully that night. And what you find happening is that the victims tend to be the ones who will have a restless night, because at the end of the day, you do not get the result that you want. And so when you confront them, you have to know that it does not change anything. And when I say it doesn't change anything, I mean that it will not change their behavior. They will not at all be apologetic. They will not be remorseful. They will have, no feelings of guilt or anything, but they will actually enjoy you expressing the pain, your sorrow, your frustrations, your anger. Narcissistic supply, positive or negative, is all good for them. They don't care as long as they are getting that supply. And so, you know, you could be animated and really expressive and feeding them. And so they'll view you as pathetic and weak for challenging them, because they truly do believe that they are superior and that they're the best. Like, and who are you to come and question them? And so, again, going back to that sleeping giant, it's like you awaken their wrath sometimes, and they kick up the evil and the wicked things that they do to people after confrontation, because it's like they feel like, okay, maybe you think you're going to get away from me, and just in case you do actually get away from me, let me squeeze some more pain out of you. Let me bring some more misery into your life. Let me interject some more regret and disappointment into your system. It is nothing more than speaking to a brick wall when you begin to get into the conversation about how they make you feel and how you're tired of them. And it's a brick wall. They don't hear you. And when I say they don't hear you, they hear the words that are coming out of your mouth, but they are not listening. There's a difference between hearing and listening. They don't care. And, you know, a lot of the times you end up going back and forth with them. And you know what? That's where you start arguing with the fool. And the problem with arguing with a fool is that they hit low below, they hit below the belt, and they drag you to their level. And then it is almost like, so, okay, who's the fool here? You start to look crazy like them when you get into that space with them where they are trying to take you. Don't allow them to pull you out of character. And what, you know, one way that they do that is by really issuing personal attacks. And, you know, these personal attacks, they are hurtful. But another thing about personal attacks is that when you decide to confront the narcissist, to them, what that signifies is a personal attack. And so as far as they're concerned, that deserves revenge, and revenge at the highest form. So they will come after you. And when they come after you, nothing is off limits. They will go for everything because you dare to challenge their false image. And they have to protect the false self at all costs. You know, with narcissists, they have black or white thinking, the splitting. You're either all good or all bad. And they want to always see you as all bad. Because if you are all bad, that signifies to them that they are all good. Now, when you challenge that false self, you're now making them think that you see them as all bad. It's crazy. No making sense of it, but that's how they think. But you know, that personal attack, you'll find now they start smear campaigns. They work to turn people against you. They want to come and ruin your relationships with children, with siblings, with family, friends, working relationships, professional relationships. They come after your standing in the community. Their evil ways are just elevated. And it's, you know, sometimes you wonder, like, can a person get more wicked? And just when you think it's impossible, they show you that they can. And when you confront a narcissist, this is exactly what ends up happening. They will show you exactly how evil they are. They're not going to change. It doesn't mean anything to them that your feelings are hurt. They know your feelings are hurt. They knew they were going to hurt your feelings from the moment they met you. It means nothing to them. And so there's no point trying to reason with them. Thank you so much for your time today. I hope that this video will help you. And I look forward to chatting with you in the next video. Until then, love yourself.